My name is Daniel Mantilla, or Daniel Mantilla. I am originally from Colombia. When I moved to the States, I was working in a small format. I was working with oil colors, and I was feeling that I was very respected with the things that I was making. So it was very exciting when I started to grab big pieces of paper, large pieces of canvas, and I started to draw some things very quickly and cutting them up. And I started to arrange those things in the wall. And it offered several possibilities for what I started to do next. Now, originally, I was thinking to work on one painting at the time, but I never do that. I'm always working on a lot of different supports simultaneously. The other thing, too, is that I have a lot of new materials, and I want to see what they can do, or what I can do with them as well. So I have a lot of different pieces of paper, different supports, wood and canvas, smaller canvases, and I've been working and trying different things with the material. And specifically using like the new cadmium free paint. That was exciting because I have always been into trying different materials and see how they affect my practice, how I make decisions in a painting based on the qualities of the materials. Thinking about the development of artistic practice from now on is the fact that they are non-toxic. So at a small level, it's nice, as I mentioned before, that is not going to have repercussions or consequences in the health of people using these materials, which I think is great. At a practical level too, now even in a lot of studios and a lot of environments, they do not want people to be working with toxic materials. So I think it's moving in that direction as well, that it opens doors to be able to work in different environments with different communities because it's non-toxic. So I think it's nice to have the option as an artist in which I could still use the same colors and the same things that I want to use, but with something that is not going to affect my health and something that is not going to affect the planet later on.